This week, mainly for an on-site brand shoot. Usually most of the time when I'm working with brands, it's content that I shoot and create and edit within my own home, but this time I'm actually out here in New York where I'll be going on site to work with a very special brand. I'm sure you guys have heard of it, Architectural Digest. It's definitely a dream come true to me. One day I hope I'll be able to have my own Architectural Digest home tour, but until then, this will have to do, and I'm super excited to be working with them. So yeah, super excited to be here and bring you guys along with me. Or AD shoot. So I think the schedule is I'm going in a few hours early to get glammed up or basically try on a bunch of different outfits that their stylists picked for me. Once we choose an outfit, I'm gonna go over sort of the script, or I don't wanna call it a script because even though I'm working with such a big brand like AD, I still didn't want it to feel like it wasn't authentically me. So before I came here, I had hopped on the phone with the creative director of the shoot and basically worked out sort of a general flow to the video, which is still staying authentic to the things that I look for within a space, while also, of course, achieving their objective, which is, for this video, basically how to decorate small spaces. They rented out a super nice house in the Brooklyn area, which we're basically staging a living room area as a studio. I'm super, super excited. I'm about to head over and I'll see you guys there. Okay, so I'm about to get dressed for the shoot. The entire set is set up and I checked everything. It looks amazing. So, let's do it. Okay, so it's now day three of me being in New York. Last night I checked into a new hotel. So I was at an Airbnb for the first few nights, and then now I'm staying at Public. Yesterday was the AD shoot, so totally done with that now. It was super fun, and it was really amazing working with their creative team and their camera team. Obviously you guys know this, but all of my videos are basically filmed in my apartment, and so it's pretty much just me, my camera, sometimes my girlfriend who helps me out a little bit. But they had like a whole production crew, like multiple camera people, a sound person, there was someone doing my wardrobe, even glam. I've never like done makeup before, but there was someone like covering my dark circles. It was a little bit tiring. It was like 6 or 7 hours of straight shooting, but I had a really great time, and it was super amazing to see such a well-established and huge brand like Architectural Digest and kind of how they do things behind the scenes. So the plan for the rest of the trip is to basically just hang out with some of my high school friends. If you guys didn't know, I actually grew up on the East Coast, and so most of my friends from high school who graduated college ended up in New York City, so I'm gonna be meeting up with some of them. Gonna get tons of good food. New York obviously has some amazing food, so I'll show you guys some of my favorite spots. Super excited about that. And then I'm also today actually meeting up with my friend Issa to go and visit a museum and then get some sushi later. So looking forward to that as well. And real quick, I wanted to give you guys a little tour of my hotel room here in Public because it is pretty unique, and it's definitely a hotel that I think is great if you're visiting New York, especially either by yourself or maybe like with one friend or significant other. All right, so this is the entrance when you first walk into the hotel room. There's the sink on the left side, and then there's the shower and toilet on the right side. As you can see, not a super huge room, but I think everything in it is designed super, super well. This is the sort of sink area. You can see there's a little bit of counter space, and then there's some hidden storage back here for like your toiletries and all the stuff that you need. There's a sink, there's a vanity mirror. Pretty minimalist, but I really love the sort of like fluted wood of this right here. And then through these sliding doors is where the bathroom is. So there's a toilet right here, and then there's the shower over here. I really like the shower. There's an on and off button, which I feel like most showers don't have. So it's super nice to turn it on and very convenient to set the temperature and all that. And then this is the main sort of bed area. So as you can see, there's like sort of a platform here with ambient lighting all the way around, which is very cool. I think it gives like a very sort of like Japanese Zen vibe. And then there's a queen size mattress in this bed. Something really cool you can do is close the blinds and the shades with a control panel on the left side, so that's super cool. Everything's very automated in here. And then on this side, there's this table with this little bench. Cool thing about this bench is that there's actually storage under here for your suitcase, which is super thoughtful, so it kind of stays out of sight. And then yeah, this obviously doubles as a seating area to chill out. And then also, if you need to get some work done like I do, you can also work at the table. But yeah, that's pretty much the entire room. Super simplistic, super well designed and thought out. Definitely a big fan. And I'm actually running a little bit late, so I'm gonna turn the camera off and then rush to meet up with Issa.
Thank you. Alexa's dreaming now, drifting off my couch. We walked down the street, she's walked 1,000 times. Time I came alive when some